Hey guys. So today is Monday. May the 4th be with you. And this is Chip. I'm eating my lunch slash breakfast, and he thinks it's part of his. I just wanted to check in. It's Monday. First Monday of May. May is Mental Health Awareness Month. I made my breakfast slash lunch. He's gonna just keep coming. So I wanted to just bring attention to this month. It's Mental Health Awareness Month, and everybody, I'm sure everybody knows someone with a mental illness, or at least if they don't know someone, they know someone that they think has a mental illness. In the last few months, I've been really tough for everybody. For people who feel lonely, people who feel judged everywhere, people who judge themselves harder than anyone else. It sucks. I think to my friends who I look to on Facebook, and I like their comments and all this stuff, and then they don't like mine, I sometimes take that personally. It's so stupid. It's so stupid. Why do I need to take that personally? Well, because I have a mental illness, and in my head I'm thinking, hey, they like that person's stuff. Why don't they like mine? It's the same type of thing. Truth is, they're living their life, and it was hard for me to really understand that. I used to take a lot of things personal with people that would want to, or people I would like their stuff and be their friend, and I felt like, hey, this isn't cool that they're not my friend back. They're not liking my stuff. They're not sharing my stuff. They're not being this. That was wrong. And for me, I want to help people, and judging them by how they live their life is not cool. And having a mental illness, being harder on myself than anyone else ever is, not believing in myself when no one else ever, when everyone else is telling me I'm special or I'm amazing or I'm great. I'm a guy that's like, no, I'm not. I haven't done shit. I have a master's degree. I raised 3 foster kids. I've done amazing things just all over the city of Cleveland, and I've built a couple restaurants. I should be proud of me, and I'm not. And I realized that a little over a year ago, and I needed to fix it. I started my own companies, CBDs that you can add into anything. Literally, I put it on top of this. I should have showed you guys in the video, but it was, it's gone, as you can see. There's nothing there. It's odorless, colorless, tasteless. It's a powder you just put on top of anything. Put it in your coffee, put it in your dog's water, put it in your favorite lotion if you want. Help yourself get a proper dose of lab-tested hemp CBD with 0 THC, so no high every time. Being the first Monday of May, Mental Health Awareness Month, and being bearded, bald, and bipolar, I wanted to start helping people. It was the point of why I created my companies and helping bring awareness to mental health and just help people wherever we can. So I wanted to give people some advice to help one another. First, you don't need my advice, but I think it's be a good idea just to try something new and outside of our box. Call a friend, send a text message to someone you haven't seen, talked to, or heard of in a while. Someone that you used to respect very dearly. Hey, how you doing? Doesn't cut it. Send them something positive that reminds them of how close you two were. That text that says, hey, remember when we went to this concert? Remember when we worked together and we did this? I just wanted you to know I was thinking of you and sending you good vibes. Share something positive today. It's a motivational Monday. Motivate somebody else. Mental health, motivation Monday. Mental Health Monday started because of a buddy of mine. Jordan and his friends all started it, and they check in on each other all the time, and they are able to just, they once a week they check in, and it's a group of guys to make sure they're all doing okay, especially in today's times. And it kind of became a very big staple for my companies and building and all that. We talk about it and how without mental health you can be in good healthy shape, but you can't be the best you. You need to be able to have this clear. And having illnesses there is just like having an illness in your body. It takes strong will and determination. I break an arm, I know it's going to take me 8 to 12 weeks before I'm able to actually have that arm back to normal. Well, if you've been mentally broken for your whole life and you don't realize that you're hurting yourself, It takes a lot longer than those 12 weeks to fix it. You have to give yourself your best for a while. When you're feeling that lowest, you need to be able to push yourself further. So for me, it was starting from the beginning. So the first thing I did, this is the beginning of May, so I'll try to post something every Monday at least, but all the time. But I know, you're trying to get to my food. So, sorry, I'm eating. But I literally was married too young. I apologize to my ex-wife. We got married way too young. And forget that. She's moved on, I moved on. But I needed something to help me clear my head because that divorce really screwed me up. As a kid, and I was in the church, I always heard to have childlike faith. And the thing that threw me to my childhood was Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. The day my divorce was finalized, I got 4 Build-A-Bears I made at of the Ninja Turtles just to get in, like, for me, keep your childlike faith. And I was trying to, and I was pushing on that, and I was, like, working on this and looking at my faith and trying to get deeper, and I kept feeling I was doing things wrong, and I wasn't adding up to what the church or what others thought of me. And I broke away from all of it, and I had a pretty big fall. Good job, good money, everything, and then I just quit it all. I needed a new start. I needed to stop hurting. Just like if my arm was broken, I needed to fix this. And all the accomplishments and accolades in the world mean nothing if I don't actually work on it. So, first thing I did was the turtles. Don't bite my laptop. So, first thing I did when I started doing things with the turtles and all that, was I realized there's 7 days in a week and there's 4 turtles. So that means if I can get, I got a calendar and stickers, for real. And my fiance and I would put the stickers, she would, at the end of the day, on the calendar. And the calendar would sit up. And if I got 4 turtles in a week, I got a dinner of my choice or something special. Thing was, it was changing my mindset, and it was that start. I needed to cover up my pain and move on, and that's hard to do. And the turtles really helped me with that. I have Raph looking like LeBron. There's gonna be a whole bunch going around there. You got Chef Mike RD, because Chef Boyardee is from Parma, Ohio, which is right by Cleveland. And he made Elbow Macaroni famous, and Melt is the famous restaurant now in Cleveland. There's a lot, but Melt was the one I went with because you get a tattoo and you get a discount. Saving money. He has a Melt tattoo on his elbow because Chef Boyardee made Elbow Macaroni famous. You got Leo over Tower City. He's watching out and he's protecting everybody in the city. And then you got Donnie guarding everything. He's a guardian of the bridge. I did all of that because I had a tattoo of a moon with my ex-wife and swirls around it, and I wanted to cover it up. It's kind of funny how the turtles work out like that, because that 4 times in a week, knowing you did good here and you worked hard and you noticed it, it's that feel-good thing. Well, I wanted to get rid of that tattoo that reminded me of her, and that feel-good thing was my reward to myself. The tattoo's still getting more work into it, but our tattoo was on our wrists, and what sucked was, it was, same song twice, but I like this song. Everything I did, I could see it, and it would trigger things, and you need to be able to get rid of those when you have mental health issues. So for me, I went and got it covered up. I had the turtles popping out of the sewers, because the shittiest part of your life needs covered up. So I covered it up with a sewer grate. Put the shit back where it goes. In the sewers. Do the same thing for your mental and emotional health. Today is Mental Health Monday, the first Monday in May of Mental Health Awareness Month. I reach out and I just say, hey, I'm sending you good vibes. Reach out to others that you may know. Find friends. I have friends that literally want to see the best of me, and we talk once a week. They check in just to make sure I'm okay, and I really love them. They bought me a book to read, The Art of Peace. I recommend everybody start diving into it. Peace is essential for you. You can never pass along joy and happiness. You have to be able to show it. My favorite quote I read this last week was, Let your actions be your words, and your words be your actions. Meaning, make my actions be the thing that stands out, so they mimic my words. I want my actions to speak for me, so my words don't need to do anything because everybody sees I'm doing it. Hey guys, I wish you all the best. May's Mental Health Awareness Month. I've said it like 12 times. Do yourself a favor. Jump on. Go connect with your friends. Reach out to people. Show love. We're all in this together. I don't care if you think we're getting out or not. I want you to be able to know that it doesn't matter. It matters that you reach out and show love to one another. Sending everybody good vibes. Wishing you the best. Thank you for today.